Hi, welcome to Uber Micro Repairs. On the healing bench today we have a Series X console. This looks a little bit beaten up, as you can see from all the marks and scrapes on it. But this does not display, and the reason being is the HDMI port is a little bit messed up. So I'll get this on a close up and you can see what we're dealing with. Here we go on the right hand side here. Whoops, yep. That one bust off, that was crushed flat to the back there. Put that there, and yeah. This right hand side here is pretty messed up. This side will be going to the HDMI encoder, so pin 1, 2, 3, 4, all of that jazz. And then over this side will be going to the ESD, and it doesn't look all that great. We've got a pin floating here. It's only the center section here that seems to have survived. So the cable has probably been jammed side to side on this. And there's more evidence of it here with the center section with this huge gap. This should be fully closed. I shouldn't be able to get the tweezers in there. So this port has been spread open. And yep, this is the result of it. Let's get this apart and get a new port on this Xbox. Pretty dusted up here, so before I continue I'm going to go and take this out into the garage, give this a full clean out, and yeah, we'll return and disassemble the system. And we're back again from the garage, so we're all cleaned out. This console can be worked on now without getting dust everywhere. And here we are with the board liberated from the chassis, and everything looks good. It's a virgin console, nothing's been done to it, so that's always good. Let's have a quick look at the HDMI port under the scope. There's the back of the HDMI port. Remember, it was on the right before, now it's on the left, so that's where most of the damage was with the pins and the plastic. So as you can see, 1, 2, 3, 4, blah, blah, blah. All of these lines go through these TVS diodes straight to the redriver, the retimer IC there, then they bugger off straight to the APU. And then we have these bunch of lines here which squirrel themselves through the board, and a bunch of them go to the ESD IC right here, and everything looks good there. Naturally, it's a untouched main board, which is good. So let's get this mounted up and get that port replaced. Okay, so we've got a preheater right here. This is going to aid in getting this port off nice and easy without stressing the board out too much. If any of you guys have ever had to do these HDMI replacements on these Xboxes, you will know just how much heat these boards take, and it can be an absolute nightmare. Alright, so we've got the board all mounted up. Just add these thermocouples to it. Okay, so we want the board to get nice and toasty. We're on sensor C here, which is on there, and we're at 93 degrees. Just give that a bit of time to heat up. Okay, so we're at about 120 degrees on the top of the board. Underneath will be hotter. As you can see there, 123. On C, which is this top one here. So what we want to do is just add a little bit of heat soaked into the board, which will just aid in getting that off without using 400, 460, 480 degree heat on the hot air, which in my opinion is not great. So I predict it should be around about 300 to 350 on the hot air, and that port should lift straight off nice and easy. Okay, so we're at about 148, give or take, so I'm happy that that's happy. Let's get this port off. Okay, so we're set to 300 on the hot air. Let's get some fume extraction on the go. Loud noises. Go, port extracted nice and easy, and yep, we're at 300, and that's up to 148, 47. Excellent. So we could literally just drop this port right in. So we'll up the temperature a little bit on that. Let's go, I've got a preset of 360, so we'll go with that. Port is on. Yep, definitely on there. Okay, so we will just turn this off, let everything cool naturally, and then we'll inspect that port under the scope and see if all them pins are on, and we'll also inspect those anchor points just to make sure that solder has actually flown through the board and bonded with the legs. So back in a minute. Okay, so it looks like we've got good flow on those anchor points and the front anchors as well. Those pins look really good. Doesn't look too bad at all. So let's just do a quick nudge test. Yeah, same good. I'm pressing quite hard on these. All of them rock solid, perfect. And as you can see, there's no plastic that started to swell or anything. All the plastic is still perfectly intact. And remember, I heated this from the top of the port, which is a big no-no, but using a preheated board, using a board preheater, you can do things like that. And the underneath looks pretty damn good to me. No issues with the ESD either. And just a quick scan over the rest of the board. Everything looks absolutely factory fresh. Perfect. Look, hardly any flux. Just a little bit of flux that's crept through those locating pins. Port is perfect. And if we look at the original one, as we saw there, that's the damaged one, and again there's no melted plastic at all. So this port actually come off with 300 degrees. So we preheated the top of the board. When I say the top of the board, I mean the HDMI side was up to 150 degrees, or as close to. And then we used 300 degrees and this port just almost fell off. And then when we put it back on, I wasn't overly sure on the temperature, so I upped it to 360 degrees, and then we planted the port on, left the heat on for a little bit. And again, heating from the top, that's unheard of. That's not something that you shouldn't normally do. But again, preheating the board, you can do things like that. And these are the results. And there we go, we don't even have to clean up. We can just send that, perfect. Okay, so there's the board. I've got a little gadget to show. So, where is it? This is a Mechanic T824, and it's got one of them Apple thingy-ma-bobs on there, and then a USB-C there. That's a charging point. And if we turn it on, what this does is it does diode readings. It will do diode readings on a controller or phone or anything like that. This will check that the port is working, and we've got all of our diode readings there. Perfect. But not only that, someone has created a breakout board for it, so it will go from USB-C to HDMI. So plug it in like so. Reset it, and then if we plug it in now, we can check whether we've got a connection or not. And it says testing. And just wait a little bit. There we go. Okay, and looking down the list, everything looks pretty damn good. Basically what my fluke tells me. Yeah, that all looks good. Pin 19 and 18, 0.67, 0.65, good. Pins, the data lines, I'm not entirely sure if these actually tally up to the exact ones. I need to check that, but everything looks good. Diode readings on everything there, and it looks pretty good. Plus we've got a bunch of test points here that we can plug a multimeter onto it and check things individually, or even inject voltage if need be. So on the face of it, that looks good. I won't bore you with the APU cleanup. You guys have seen that probably 1,000 times. Just look at my other Xbox videos on how I clean this up. So I'll skip that bit, we'll speed run the reassembly, and we'll get to testing. Okay, I'm 100% certain that this port is soldered on correctly, but I'm 98% sure that this will display. Remember, you do have the retimer and you have the ESD IC, and looking at this port, it was a bit mangled. So, answers on a postcard, will it display? Okay, so we've got it in OBS here. This is going through the capture card. Diode readings were good. Port looked good. Stays on. Fan spinning. OBS has detected something. Yay, there we go. Don't worry. Cool. And there we go. Are you going to the dashboard? Oh, there's a disc in there. There we go. Cool. Excellent. Call of Duty Black Ops 3. And let's go over to the settings. We're in 720, it is detecting. Let's just check the details out. Okay, HDR 10, 4K 60, it is capable. Keep this resolution, yes. I need to reset the size quite a bit. There we go, cool. Video modes, they're all on. Fidelity, auto. Cool, there we go. It's displaying in 4K. I've just got to put the back on. But as you saw, the preheater does an excellent job of removing these ports. The acid test for that preheater will be removing the retimers on these boards, because if you've ever replaced a retimer on a Series X board, you will know that you will need the hot air at about 460 to 480, and trying to get that tiny little IC off them boards, it's almost as if it's welded on. And I've seen some pretty horrific, shall we say, home repairs, because they haven't pumped enough heat into the board. Not only that, all the plastic underneath the caps is starting to melt. You've got that giant 12 volt connector, which is really close by, plus the storage expansion card as well. You're pumping a ton of heat into the board that ought not to be. So doing things correctly is what we're about, and that preheater is absolutely spot on. Yes, it does add a little bit of time to the job and a little bit of setup, but the results speak for themselves. We hot aired this off and then we put a new one on, and we hot aired it from the top of the port. Remember that, the top of the port. There you go. Anyway, I hope you enjoyed the video. If you have any issues with consoles, controllers, or any other device that you feel we can help you with, please get in contact. All of our details are in the description below, and take care.